So hey everybody, here we are. We are going to be looking at, watching, and reacting, possibly reviewing, the DiVinyls music video for I Touch Myself, because it came up on our most recent episode of Song Swap Showdown. As we were sharing our guilty pleasure songs, this was one of your guilty pleasure songs, Amanda Sharp.
It sure was. It sure was.
And as we found out, it's also a karaoke song of yours.
Yeah, which Chris very much knew to ask, did you realize what this meant when you first sang it? And I agreed that no, I did not. So can you imagine?
I can't imagine. But then again, I can, because it's you. Right? So it makes it even better.
I mean, my world, I do live under that rock. I do. But I was so bold and brave enough. The Michigan Rock. I was so bold and brave enough to just get up there and belt it, though, like I understood it.
People must have been like, wow. You, like, are really confident in control of yourself. Like, you go, girl.
And who knew ignorance is the way to get to confidence?
Ignorance is bliss.
Ignorance is bliss. I guess it's that same for a reason.
So while you were talking about how much you liked the song and all that, then it also came out that you'd never seen a music video for this, or at least you didn't think that you'd seen a music video.
I don't think I have.
And I actually haven't seen this in years. I mean, I remember the song, obviously, sure. A huge hit. We discovered, which I couldn't even believe, actually, it came out in 1991. So I was like, wow, I can't even believe it came out that long ago. So we said, well, why don't we watch the music video? Let's do this. So this is the DiVinyls. I Touch Myself, which says remastered in HD now. So
I'm so
285 likes, by the way. No dislikes. I just want to point that out.
Just to be clear,
no one dislikes this song.
I mean, it's a solid song. Oh,
look at these colors.
Cleavage. Okay.
Of course.
Ooh, I want bangs like that. Okay.
I mean, this is a great music. This is a really good music video. I feel like I see stuff like this on TikTok now.
Yeah.
Like,
oh my gosh. You know what I'm saying? You're so right.
Like, this is 1991, and like, I feel like this. You see this on TikTok now.
You are so right, Chris.
What a solid tune.
Oh, there's like a person inside, like whatever that thing was. Okay.
I love this though. Like, that black and white looks so good.
Oh.
little contortionist there.
Ooh, seductive.
This would never have been allowed on in the
Patrick.
Amanda. The Patrick household.
No. My mom would have said, turn this filth off.
Would you be okay with if Owen was watching this?
I'm sure he's already watched something worse.
I mean, he is a teenage boy now.
He's 16. I would be... This is so PG compared to probably what's in videos now for him to consume.
I mean, these guys look super cool, though.
They really do. I feel like, and maybe I'm wrong, I feel like the girls, at least, could literally walk into the 2023s and be like, they match.
Yeah.
Maybe not that outfit.
Right. Maybe not that outfit, but.
But I really think all of the hair, the outfit,
right,
the sweet, totally apply to 2023.
I'm telling you, it's like, I watched this and it's like, yeah, this is super early 90s. And like, this aesthetic
is.
You could see this on TikTok now.
Yes.
Or Instagram,
The boots, I mean, I really...
what a great song, though. I, like,
oh, no.
Really, like, listening to this again, like, reminded me how good this is.
It really is.
This is a good karaoke song.
This is and that's why I was drawn to it. Drawn. I really want those bangs. Not the butts, but bangs.
The bangs. I want to be clear. I also feel like this is a good way to do a song like this that is so blatantly obvious in the lyrics, but like, sexy, cool, tasteful music video.
It's very tasteful. I mean, it's seductive, but what else do you think you're going to get from this song?
Yeah.
I don't hate it. I'm not mad about it.
You're not mad about this.
I'm not mad about this.
Unfortunately, she passed away.
I didn't realize that.
Yeah, it was a few years ago she passed away from cancer.
That's terrible.
Yeah.
I'm impressed with us that this was on our show today. I feel like we're just, watch this song be in a movie or series, and it makes a comeback.
I think this wasn't a series or a movie. Let me. Oh, you're saying like how like Stranger Things,
and takes like it up to the charts. Yeah.
Wednesday. Yeah. I mean, and that's been such a reoccurring theme lately. Oh, so yeah, this was actually in. Oh, that's right. I forgot about this.
You're like, oh, that's right.
I completely forgot. Like, it's been so long, but this was actually in Austin Powers. It's when the fembots steal his mojo.
When was that movie? When was that movie released?
1997.
So really appropriate time frame.
Yeah.
I can't believe that's that old. We're old.
It really is. Wait, so Christine Amphlett of the DiVinyls, she passed away from breast cancer and multiple sclerosis on April 21st, 2013 at the age of 53.
So young and a double whammy. Ouch.
Before she died, she expressed hope that I Touch Myself would remind women to perform annual breast examinations, is what she had said.
Oh, that gave me goosebumps.
So I'm just reading that now on some of the notes here.
You know what? You know what? Chris, when we get together and we're in person and we're doing our karaoke thingamabob that we're going to do at some point in this world.
We're doing this song.
We're going to do the song.
And then we're going to do Party in the USA.
Yes. And then to honor her, I will say, hey, ladies, don't forget to do your self-checks.
There you go.
And then I won't feel so dirty about performing such a song.
Oh, here's another thing, by the way.
Not to diminish your positive
messaging. Yeah. That I didn't even realize. So Michael Bay directed this music video.
Who's Michael Bay?
Michael Bay. He was the director of like Transformers, and he also directed Bad Boys. Like he's a huge action star director. Like The Rock, I think The Rock or Air.
Interesting. That's why it must be so wonderful.
Another Nick Cage movie. But yeah, he huge action director, Michael Bay. But yeah, he went on, he directed this music video, and he also directed music videos for Tina Turner and Meatloaf. His first feature film was Bad Boys, released in 1995. Great movie, by the way.
That was such a good movie.
Great movie.
So fun. So funny. It's just so great. That was a great video.
It is a good video. I like it. It
was very well done. It probably was very risky for 91, I'm assuming. But I look at it now and I go, wow, I guess we're so desensitized to what we see now in movies all the time.
Yeah.
That, like, to me, this was very respectively done.
Honestly, I had no idea Michael Bay did this. I'm, like, kind of blown away right now. Michael Bay was the director of this video, like, considering, like, and seeing what he's got on to do. Like, you know, basically the father of explosion porn, as they call it. Like, you know, because everything's, like, giant explosions in his movies. But, yeah, it was fun actually going back and rewatching it. It's been a long time.
I respect it even more now. I really do. After reading what she said, watching the video, it was very respectfully done. I don't feel so ashamed that I karaoke'd this without really knowing. I don't. The more you know, the better you feel about your past.
Yeah.
I know that's not the same, but that's where I took it today.
That's where you took it. So. Well, thank you all so much for hanging out with us and watching us talk about the DiVinyls, I Touch Myself music video. If there's any videos you would like to see us react to, let us know in the comments below. We'd love to do it, and we'll see you guys next time. Make sure you hit that follow, like, subscribe button, reshare this, do all the things, and we'll see you guys soon.